Daredevil 2003 is an interesting movie. I mean, it definitely could have been a lot better, but I overall think that it's a mostly enjoyable movie, especially the director's cut. I honestly think that Ben Affleck could have done a lot more with the Daredevil character. Something that I've always found interesting is how obviously inspired by Spider-Man this movie was, and that got me thinking, with no small part, of course, to my fan Jay's watch, what if those two movies were in the same universe? What if Tobey Maguire Spider-Man and Ben Affleck Daredevil shared a city? Simply put, what if Spider-Man was in Daredevil? So somehow, Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man is in the same universe as Ben Affleck's Daredevil. So what happens next? How does Spider-Man affect the events of Daredevil? Well, I think at first the movie would be mostly the same. Daredevil would still be a relatively new hero in New York, and as of now, he has not crossed paths with Spider-Man. When Nick Manolis talks to Ben Urich about Daredevil killing Jose Quesada, he asks him not to write a story on it, not just because of Daredevil, but because of Spider-Man and Daredevil. He says that there's already two vigilantes running around New York and he doesn't want any more. It should be noted here that Peter Parker in this movie is in between the first and second movies, so he's established and is through the early growing pains of being Spider-Man, at least the public perception, but he's starting to struggle a lot with balancing his life around Spider-Man like he was in the second movie. So his life is starting to go bad now. This is when the seeds of the direction he would go in Spider-Man 2 are planted. Peter doesn't really know how to feel about Daredevil. I mean, he wants to trust Daredevil because if New York has another protector that's as good-hearted as him, then maybe they won't rely on him so much and he can take the breaks he needs to get his life back on track. But before he has time to make up his mind about Daredevil, J. Jonah Jameson desperately wants Peter to take pictures of him because he's excited. He immediately feels like he has a proper hero to endorse against Spider-Man because, of course, that's just what I think he would do. Either that or he would be like, oh, Daredevil and Spider-Man are awful together. Whatever, but he still wants pictures of him, and Peter agrees to be on the lookout for him and try to get pictures. This finally gives Peter the kick in the ass he needs to actually try and look for Daredevil. So the rest of the movie plays out relatively the same from this point on, I'm gonna say, all the way up until Matt Murdock and Elektra have their rooftop kiss. Matt hears people in trouble and he leaves her to go fight crime as Daredevil. He confronts a street thug and he tells him to stay out of Hell's Kitchen. The thug then spits on him, and Daredevil is about to continue beating him to a pulp when he meets Spider-Man for the first time standing behind him in the hallway. Daredevil turns around to look at him when he sees a young boy terrified of him curled up in the corner of the room. This really hurts him and he tries telling him that he's not the bad guy, and Spider-Man just tells him to prove he's not the bad guy and not keep beating up this criminal, and Daredevil agrees, putting his fist down. He and Spider-Man then take the thug into the police together. That boy being terrified of him has really gotten to Daredevil, and now he realizes just how badly the city really views him despite all the good he's trying to do. He's honestly really crushed by this, and he asks Spider-Man how he got people to not be afraid of him, and Spider-Man says that there is a fine line between making criminals fear you and making everybody fear you. I mean, everybody's going to fear you at least a little bit. You're always going to have your detractors, but you have to try and show people that you mean to help them by not doing more than you need to. He tells him that with great power comes great responsibility. Daredevil then asks him how he knows that Spider-Man himself hasn't killed anybody. And Spider-Man just says truthfully that the only people who ever died when he was fighting them died of their own accord. Daredevil hears through his heartbeat that he was being honest, and he knows that Spider-Man can be an ally now. Later on in the movie, when Kingpin sends Bullseye to kill Nicholas Nachios and he throws the billy club to kill him, Spider-Man actually catches the club before it can kill him, and he helps Daredevil to apprehend Bullseye. The police then try to get information out of Bullseye, but he's not talking, so he just goes off to prison. So now Nicholas is not killed, and Matt and Elektra actually continue their relationship, and she doesn't try to kill him later on when he's Daredevil. Instead, she tries to kill Bullseye because, yeah, I mean, her father's alive, but she still wants to kill him because, Well, he tried to kill her father. So she actually puts on a mask and she tries breaking into prison, only to find that he's not there anymore. He's been broken out by Kingpin, who then seemingly kills Elektra with a bullet to the chest. Daredevil arrives too late, unfortunately, and he hears her heartbeat seemingly stop. She's still going to be alive, of course, just like in the real timeline. You could do that necklace with the Braille on at the end. But for now, Daredevil thinks that she is dead. Later on in the movie, Karen Page and Foggy Nelson discover the connection of Wesley Owen Welch to Kingpin. He reveals Kingpin's identity as Wilson Fisk, but before the police arrive, Daredevil and Spider-Man work together to fight Kingpin and Bullseye. Ultimately, Spider-Man apprehends Bullseye, while Daredevil breaks Kingpin's legs. Daredevil almost kills him, but he spares him, much to Spider-Man's relief. And now at the end of the movie, Spider-Man and Daredevil talk, and Spider-Man tells him that he'll keep in touch if he ever needs help again. He's a friendly neighborhood Spider-Man. Daredevil then just smiles at him and says, "Not this neighborhood. I've got this neighborhood." The movie then ends with them swinging off in different directions. And that is what I think would happen if Spider-Man was in Daredevil 2003. Overall, I think it's an interesting timeline. It's not a necessary timeline, but it would really help to flesh out this version of New York City, which I already think was fairly fleshed out in Daredevil 2003. New York City never really felt small scale to me in that movie, but including Spider-Man would just bring it up to a whole nother level, in my opinion. Now, do I think Spider-Man would improve the movie? Maybe, because I think that obviously, the best scenes from Daredevil were cut, unfortunately. Like, that whole sequence with the boy being scared of Daredevil, that was not in the theatrical version. That's in the director's cut. And honestly, I think if Spider-Man was involved, there's no way that would have been left on the cutting room floor. That would have been in it. And I do think that overall, Daredevil might have been a bigger success, for sure, if Spider-Man had been in it. So, yeah, we probably would have gotten a Daredevil 2, and Daredevil might have actually appeared in Spider-Man 2, who knows? We could have been planting the seeds of an earlier prototype MCU right here, because that Punisher cameo in Spider-Man 2 doesn't count, in my opinion. So yeah, overall, I don't think that Daredevil 2003 is actually that bad of a movie. The director's cut especially is actually a pretty solid movie, I would say. Not like the greatest superhero movie in the world or anything, but like, it's definitely better than the theatrical version. Like, it's definitely like a C-tier film. But I like watching Daredevil every once in a while. It's a fun little movie. And, you know, the corniness stuff is so fun, you just can't help but smile at it. And the dark stuff really works, in my opinion, for the most part. So I really think that Daredevil is an underrated movie. And of course, Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man is excellent. So yeah, I definitely see a lot of potential in these two crossing over. But that's just my opinion on what would happen if they had crossed over. But anyway, guys, let me know what you think in the comments down below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up. Share this video with all of your friends and all your various social media platforms. Leave me more what-if recommendations in the comments down below. And I will see all you guys in the next video.